In order to know how to write a video description on YouTube, we have to look at the above the fold part and the below the fold part, as well as what a viewer will read and what the algorithm will read. So let's dive in. Hey YouTubers, Nico here. Let's look at a video description of one of our YouTube grandfathers and SEO expert, Derral. With what he writes above the fold, that's what we see without clicking show more, he gets straight to the point. Because the above the fold part is what the viewers are most likely to read, he wrote it in a clever way to tell us everything we need to know. Part 1. Okay, it's a video series. Then, how does the algorithm work? This tells us what the video is about. Looking for more video views on YouTube? This should actually end with a question mark. But anyway, I now know why I should watch it. This is the first video in this series. Alright, more knowledge will be coming our way. And to help content creators on YouTube get more visibility and views for their videos. That's what I will learn from this series. Excellent, I'm convinced to watch. Keep in mind that this above the fold part of the description is not only visible below the video, but also on the search results page. That makes the above the fold part especially important. So make your first few sentences count. That said though, people aren't the only ones who read video descriptions. The YouTube algorithm does too. So what Derral did here is cleverly optimizing the description for the algorithm at the same time. But before we have a close look at the SEO perspective, let's look at the below the fold part of the description to see what else is there for the viewers to read. Obviously, next come the links relevant for the video. Here he links to the next part of the series. And then we have the affiliate links. After that, there is a very interesting section. Be the next lucky subscriber to get an in-depth channel evaluation. Here are the steps to become a VIP subscriber, so to say. I really like this section because it helps with the engagement. That actually reminds me that I use a very similar structure for my own descriptions. Above default, I start with a few sentences that motivate people to watch the video. Then, below the fold, I add follow-up links that I mentioned in the video, like the channel I recommended checking out and an informative blog post related to what I discussed in the video. At this point, Derral adds his affiliate links, but I don't have any. So moving on. Next, I also have a sentence that helps with the engagement. Have a question that deserves a video response? Leave me a comment with hashtag AskMorningFame. And then I always add a section that describes my channel for those people to read who just found my channel. That shall help convincing them to subscribe. Alright, that's a rundown of how to write a video description so that our viewers have something useful to read. Teaser, follow-up links, affiliate links, which I don't have, ask for engagement, channel description. But how about the SEO part? Well, although everything looks like being written for humans, search terms are cleverly baked into it for the algorithm to read. Let's look at Derral's above the fold description again. How does the YouTube algorithm work is actually a search term. When we enter it into the search bar, how does the U? Then it is suggested here. Using the search bar this way is how we know that this is a search term that people use when searching on YouTube. And here is the next search term, video views on YouTube. Just enter video views and the search term is suggested. Excellent. The next search term is content creators on YouTube and then get more views. Clever, right? These search terms are baked into the description and the algorithm can read them, which gives the video an SEO boost. And humans can still read everything because they are part of natural sentences. Actually, the master of baking search terms into the description is Brian G. Johnson. Let's look at one of his descriptions. He extends the teaser for the video beyond the above the fold part. Not necessarily because the viewers may read it, but to give the algorithm useful information to digest. Still, the whole section is using well-readable sentences, but they are packed with search terms. YouTube SEO, YouTube SEO tips, YouTube SEO tips and tricks, get more views, optimize your videos, more views on YouTube, YouTube SEO tips 2018, how can I get more views, and so on. Well, I bet you get the idea what it means to weave in search terms. So keep in mind that descriptions have two purposes, being useful for our viewers and providing search terms for the algorithm. For the viewers, we generally have a structure like this: teaser, follow-up links, affiliate links, ask for engagement, channel description, and maybe some legal text. On the other hand, we have search terms weaved into the description to feed the algorithm. Alright, I have two videos for you. Nowadays, we should also weave hashtags into the description. It doesn't matter where we add them, but they become more and more important. Watch this video for more information about them. And here is an unlisted video that explains how Morningfame helps you to weave the search terms into your description for a powerful SEO boost. Cheers, my friends!